Hey everyone, welcome to the new session machine learning project using a student data set to predict their grade. But before start the session, let me introduce that Grade Learning has came up with the brilliant idea of Grade Learning Academy. If you just write Grade Learning Academy in the Google and if you just click on the link, then you can directly redirect to this particular website, and here you will get almost 80 plus free courses, and after complete your course you can claim your certificate as well. And if you want to do these courses in your mobile application, that is also possible using Grade Learning app. So guys, just let me know I am audible or not. If I am audible, then please put a yes comment for that we can start the session. And in the meantime, let me just go you through the total website. What are the things you will get over there? You will get all the free courses over here. These are the domains you can see: the data science, machine learning, AI, IT and software. These are the domain you have, and under this domain you will have lots of courses, right? If you click on this domain, you can directly see what are the courses you have. And after complete the course, the main catch is here: after complete the course you will get your certificate, and you will get lots of learning material that you need to boost up your knowledge as well, right? So yeah, it's pretty much about this. And I often used to get the questions that where we will get all the materials what we are going to use for this particular live session. So you can see where you will get. If you go to this particular website, right, our moderator anyway will going to send you this link for all the material. Then also I just wanna keep you heads up on that. You can see if you go over here, you will, under upcoming live session, you will get this particular one, machine learning project on student grade prediction. If you click, if you register for this particular course, and if you just register it, and you will get all the session details and this particular live session recorded version as well, right? So this is pretty much about the Grade Learning Academy. I hope you guys are quite clear with it. And okay, I can see lots of yes. Cool. So I can see you guys able to hear me. So let's start with the data, with the session, right? So let's have a look at what are the thing we are going to cover in today's agenda. But before that, if you guys can give me a idea about how many of you actually hear the term machine learning and have an idea about Python. So if you know machine learning, then please in the comment section write machine learning. And if you know Python, then also write Python. And if you know both, then please write Python and machine learning. For that, I will understand how many of you have idea about Python. How many of you have heard the term machine learning as well? Yes, Shujit, we are going to build this particular project over here, right? So today we are going to do a big project. So I am not going to spend a lot of time for the theory, but yeah, we will start with the project itself, right? Python, I can see Priyanshu is saying Python. Okay, what else? Chava, Vikash is saying machine learning and Python. Both, I don't know. It's totally fine. You don't know if you don't know. Okay, so I can see majority of you guys have idea about machine learning, little bit about Python as well. Who have no idea about that? That's not also the problem. They can start their journey with this session as well, right? I hope it's interesting for you guys as well. So let's start with what is the agenda we have for this particular session. So first we are going to talk about why do we need machine learning. So here the main catch is we need to understand that why this term is getting so popular these days. I mean, if I am a beginner to it, so I should have think about what actually this particular thing have that for that it's getting so popular and every company are trying to hire a machine learning engineer or a data scientist, right? And then we will have a look at, after we will understand that why do we need this particular term, right? After that we will talk about what is this particular thing is all about, right? After that we will see what is the life cycle to build a machine learning model. Then we will jump into the supervised learning. We will see what are the types of machine learning we have. And lastly, we will do the project on student grade prediction using ML. So we are not going to waste any more time. Let's start with why do we need machine learning. And in between, guys, again, if you really like the video, please do hit like and also subscribe Great Learning for new upcoming courses we are going to have. And I think that will help you to build your career in data science and machine learning both. And guys, if you have any doubt, please do let me know in the live chat. I will try to help you out. And if not in the live chat, then obviously after the live session, please don't forget to comment. I will give you the answer for all your doubts, right? So let's start with why do we need machine learning? So I'm not going to give you any theoretical, explanation that why do we need machine learning. I just want to give you a practical scenario. For that, you will say, okay, this is the reason for that we need machine learning. Yeah. So let me give you an example out of it. So basically, suppose you have your own company. You are the owner of the company for suppose like Swiggy or Zomato, right? So you have your company. Your company is doing well, but you want your company to be more successful with this. This is the all objective for every company has, right? Yes. So in this case, what you need to do, maybe you said, okay, I can hire more employee or I should give some discount on that. Who is going to decide that you are going to hire more employee or you need to give some discount or you need to change your business strategy, right? So this is the main question you have when you try to find it out, how can you actually expand your business? So in this case, what you have? Try to think what you have and how can you solve your problem. So in this case, you have your data. For all the time you actually, when your business start from till now, you have your data that how many customers has actually ordered from your company, how many company are collaborate with you, right? So all these things you have. Now you just need to analyze them. But you are being a business owner, you have no idea that maybe you have, but you have no proper concrete idea that how to get started with. Yes, that time you need some person who has a good idea about data. So if you talk about machine learning, if you talk about artificial intelligence, or if you talk about, you know, business analyst, data analyst, all need only one thing, that is data. Now there are few things comes into the picture. When we talk about data, so you can say just information. No, there are lots of things we have under data. So when your data is, you have a lot of data about your company, but the data has lots of noises. Not now, if I can give that noise in a layman term, there are messy data you have. I mean, there is no proper column for your data. There is no proper, spelling in your data. The spelling mistakes are there. There is no proper, structured way you stored your data. So there are lots of things can be happen as a messy data. Right? So when you have a data like this, do you really feel you can use your data? No. Obviously, that data cannot give you any feedback or any insights about your business. That's where we need a data scientist or a data analyst, right? So when we talk about the difference between data scientist and a data analyst, we will talk about that. And that's also like, when you have a data, after that, you need a machine learning engineer, right? So in this case, first, when you actually sort your data, you make your data really pricey after, converting those messy data in a structured way. After that, your data analyst comes into the picture. So you are, when you are actually changing your messy data to a messy data to a actual good data, a pricey data, that time your data analyst do all the thing. We will see in the like building a machine learning life cycle, we will see how they are doing. But yeah, they do these things and they make a report out of it. After they make a report out of it, a data scientist look into the report. They try to understand what type of a data you have. After that, they build a model using machine learning algorithms, right? That's where machine learning engineers comes into the picture, right? So these all terms like business analyst, data scientist, and machine learning engineer, data architect, all of them are quietly, related to each other. And that is where we need these particular persons to understand our business, to understand our data, right? So if you don't understand your data, you cannot forecast your business, right? You cannot say where is the problem you are having in your particular, right now in your business, for that you can make that gap and you can expand your business. You can do some good thing in your particular business as well to make your customer satisfied, right? That is why we can say we need machine learning. Any doubt till so far, guys? image segmentation, Vikash. Not in this session, guys, maybe next in the session, we will come up with the session for image segmentation. So if you do have any idea about the session, please do let us know in the comment. That will be very helpful for us. Any doubt that why do we need machine learning? If you don't have any doubt, then we will jump into what is machine learning. Right, so now we will have a look at, we understand what is machine learning. So basically, in short, one line, we can say we can convert our data, right? We can actually use our data in order to make a model out of it. Now we will say this making a model out of it, it's a process. It's one particular algorithm. What it is, right? I don't have any idea about ML. Yes, let me give you an example of what is machine learning. So machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence. So whenever we talked about any AI, right? Yes, Nasri, I just don't get the name. Okay, I will talk about all the, like, I will explain about the algorithms as well. Okay, I will give you an answer, guys. Let me just finish what is machine learning and then I will give you an answer. Right? So now, as we were talking about the machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence is nothing but an umbrella. Right? So you will ask me, what is umbrella? What you are actually talking about? So when we talk about, hey, I know artificial intelligence, there are lots of things comes into the picture, guys. There are lots of things, right? So this comes big data, it comes machine learning. I don't want to make you confused, but yes, you will learn a part of artificial intelligence. To learn a full artificial intelligence, you need to know lots of things, right? There are lots of algorithms are there. There are lots of processes are there. There are lots of concepts actually are there under artificial intelligence, right? It basically allows the system to automatically learn and improve from experience without being explicitly programmed. Now we will say, why are you actually giving me so many, you know, hard terms? No, I am not giving you any hard terms. Let me give you an example of what actually I want to talk about. So basically, when you have a data set, right? Think about in that way. When you have a data set, right? You know, you have data. Your data is a pricey data. Why I'm talking about it's a pricey data? Because your data is not in a messy way. Now your data in a structured way. Before start with machine learning, do you know that if you have a structured way data, that can be sold as well? Lots of people try to buy a structured data to do the analysis. Yes, that is how this data is, you know, so much pricey. So in this case, when you have data, machine learning has few algorithms. We have few types of machine learning. We will talk about that. When we have few types of machine learning, under these types of machine learning, we have few algorithms. Those algorithms basically help us to make a model out of it. Suppose what model I am talking about? Suppose you have a data where you will try to find it out. Right, where we try to find it out, this particular transaction is a fraud transaction or not. Maybe you try to find it out, your flight will be delayed or not, right? Or you try to understand what are the people segment you have in your customer base. So doing those things, you have an algorithm who will work as a human, right? So when you have a data, your model algorithm will try to work as a human to make your life easy. Right, and try to give you few insights from your data which will actually help you to make a proper report out of it. Right, so this is what machine learning stands for. Right, so this is all about what is machine learning. Now I will give your questions, that I can see lots of questions are coming. Can we explain about algorithms? I will talk about that. Rajya is saying, what's the difference between data analysis and business analyst? So basically, data analysis is someone who try to understand the data. Business analysis is someone who will look into the data, who will look into the report and give you a solution for your business. Right? I hope you got your answer, Rajya. What re-explain you are asking about, Arihant? What would it be the time period of this live session? 1 hour, guys. What is means explicitly is programmed? So basically, explicitly programmed, we actually want to mean by that I have explained few seconds ago. So you have to, like, you need to build your model using those data one time. It's a one-time thing, So one that you need to make your model out of it, and then whenever you give a new data to your model, it will automatically work for you, right? So you don't need to write code every time. Okay. I really don't know, can we implement machine learning in SAP or not, right? I didn't work on SAP. I'm really sorry for that, right? Okay, I hope you got your answer, guys. Whatever the questions I got, I try to answer again. So now we will have a look at what's the difference between traditional versus machine learning. What do you think, guys? What's the difference between them? So let me give you a heads up on that. So whenever we do a normal traditional programming, what we do, we just give our data, we do our programming, and we get the output, as simple as that. But in the case of machine learning, what we do, we give the data. We make a model out of it using the algorithms. After that, you get an output. But when you give the data for the second time, you don't need to use an algorithm, right? Yes, you already make a model out of it. You don't need to write code. Your code is that much efficient enough to work as a human being. Don't you think it's really interesting? Your program is working like a human almost. I cannot say that all the time your program is perfectly fine, no, but there will be, like, you know, human error also there, but you know, most of the cases what you will get, almost 99 or 98% accuracy from your model. Yes, this is how the machine learning differ from traditional programming, right? So yeah, this is pretty much, we have talked about the traditional programming versus machine learning. Now the most interesting part of life cycle to build a model with machine learning, right? We will talk about that, and then we will jump into one particular algorithm we are going to use for today's model, and then we will see our data set, we will do our coding, right? So who has the idea about that? I'm just requesting you to keep tuned, because who are new to it, I just want to give a quick heads up on what is machine learning and how to build a model with machine learning, right? So in this case, first start with the first step of understanding the business problem. So in this case, what I can say, what actually you are trying to saying by business problem. Okay, again, I'm not going to give you any particular theory. I can give you an analogy for it. How can you understand this particular thing? Suppose again, you have your company like Swiggy, Zomato, Uber, Ola, right? So now you have hired few data scientists, okay? So you have hired your few data scientists, data analysts, business analysts. Now what you have asked them, you said, hey, I have my data, you know about my business, now give me your insights about my business, and also give me a solution for how can I actually make my customers more happy, how can I make a more sales out of my business, and a few more questions as well. So when I'm giving you a two particular different questions, you cannot approach them same way, right? When I talked about you have to do a sales prediction, you need to use some different algorithm, you need to look into the few different parts of the data. When we talk about I just want to make my customers happy out of my business, that time you need to look some customer details, what that customers order previously, like the recommendation system, as we all know that Amazon, Flipkart, right, gives us that, and Netflix as well gives us, like, if you go for watching some movies, the similar movies they used to give, right? So this is how they actually try to make their customers happy. So you can totally understand. Okay, so do we need to, I will answer your questions, guys. Please keep tuned for that. I'm really sorry. I will answer your questions, right? So yeah, so do you really think that if your business problem is not clear, you don't know what objective you need to approach, you can go for building your model? No, right? Yes, this is how this particular machine learning works, okay? Suppose for my case, I take an example of I try to make my customers happy. So basically, I need to look into the customer details, customer segmentation, and also what are the customers, is same type of customer, what are the thing they are actually going to order, right? So suppose someone ordered pizza and someone ordered maybe momo, right? So maybe I can see their order list are quite similar, so I can suggest something from others order list, right? Maybe they will like it, right? So this is how we can do this recommendation. Okay, so this is the basic part that you have to understand the business problem. When you actually understand the business problem, now you will look into the data. So you know what objective you have to reach. Then you have to go for data collection. This data collection is known as data acquisition. So the company itself is going to give you few data, but that's not sufficient, right? The more data you have, the more pattern you will get, the more information you will get. So there are few repositories we have. From there you can actually collect the data. So try to mix and match both the data and try to use them. This is the next part. Third part is when you are company is going to give you a data and the repository you are going to use. As we all know, those data will not be in a good structure. They will be obviously in a very messy way. Now, what we need to do, we just need to handle those data. How can we handle it? We need to go for data cleaning. Yes, data cleaning is the most time consuming part and it's going to take a lot of time from you. But trust me, it's going to give you a very, pricey data, that's same as gold, we can say, right? Right. So data cleaning we do to get a proper proper structured data, which can give us a proper information about the business. After that, when we do the data cleaning and when we see that our data is quite okay and we can start doing the analysis, we go for exploratory data analysis. Now this part comes, what is EDA? In short, we say this is a exploratory data analysis known as EDA. So what is EDA? So there are, when we talk about as a data scientist, we need to know few things. We need to know linear algebra. We need to have an idea about statistics. Yes, EDA is nothing but the basics of statistics, which will give you a basic idea about your data. What type of your data, we have few types about the data. We will talk about that. It will basically give you what is the count of your data. Do your data have any missing value? I mean, there is a column is there, but there is no value. So everything you will get from this particular part, and you will have a good hands-on on your data. When you know your data in a very good structured mannered way, you can go for using machine learning. In this particular part, as we said, machine learning have few types. So in this type, from those types, we can actually find our proper algorithm, which we can use for our particular model. So after we choose our particular algorithm from this, lots of variety from machine learning algorithms, we will try to build our model. That time we will give our data, right? So that when we actually build our model, from there, we try to predict our model. So maybe in the training phase your model is working really good and you get a accuracy of 99%. Now you give a new data to your model and your model start working very bad. So your model is not ready. You need to find it out what are the things it's not working correctly with your model. So the next part is giving new data to your model to predict the accuracy. After that, you need to deploy your model. What is deploying? When you know your data, your model is working really fine, you can say, hey, I can see my model is working really fine in some of, if someone wants to use my model, they can use my model. So I am going to deploy it. Deploying part is a little bit complicated, but yeah, for this particular session, you don't need to have a look into it. But yeah, deploying is something, it's someone, if you want to give your data like model to be used by someone else, right? So this is the whole life cycle of machine learning. Any doubt till so far, guys? I will answer all your question in this particular timing. So I get, can we say mesh modeling outputs for data and business analysis? Can we say ML modeling outputs for data and business analysis? I didn't get your question, Saurav. If you can explain me in a more better way. How can I get junior business analysis internship? Please help me, ma'am. Okay, so getting a business analyst internship, we do have lots of videos, guys. If you really want to check that, what are the top 20 certificate you can go for doing, or what are the things you need to know for business analysis, you can go and check that out. But internship, you have to keep an eye on Naukri and some other website where they used to post it, right? And now this is lots of remotely internship are happening. If you can check that out in the LinkedIn as well, Ritika, you will get a good number of internship. not Ritika, Rajia, right? Rajia, you can get your answer if I'm not wrong. Ritika is asking, do we able to do this project without any knowledge of Tamil? Yes, we will. We start with the basics, right, Ritika? You can do that. Himanshu, there are lots of algorithms we have. So in this case, we have few types of machine learning as well. I will talk about that. Okay, I came late. That's not the problem. We will get the recorded version of it. Right, so yeah, this is pretty much about the machine learning building part. And if you really like the video, Blin, please do like the video. And if you want to get updated with a new project from Great Learning and new course from Great Learning, then please subscribe Great Learning. Right, and yeah, we do have a project on Python. If you really want to check it out using OpenCV, that face detection using Python, real-time face detection, you can check them out. I think that will help you if you are new to it. If you want to learn few things, new exciting things about Python, you can check them out. And for machine learning, we have a whole course for machine learning. If you want to do all the algorithms, some of you are asking about algorithms. If you really want to learn all these algorithms, you can check them out. That is also for free, guys. Please do let us know what are the new things you want to learn from us. Okay, I get lots of questions, guys. So I will answer them. First, let's have a look at what the types of machine learning we have. We have three types of machine learning. One is supervised learning, one is unsupervised learning, one is reinforcement learning. So what is supervised, unsupervised and reinforcement learning? How can you actually differentiate them? So first, let me give you an idea about what is supervised learning. That's really interesting, guys. So first, supervised learning is nothing but you will have a supervisor. Now the question comes, from where I will get a teacher who is going to teach my model, right? Yes, I will give you the answer for that. So in supervised learning, in simple word, you can say, for your model learning, there will be a teacher, right? So this is why this is named as supervised learning. When we talk about unsupervised learning, we will not have any teacher for our model. And your model will start from learning from itself. That is why it is unsupervised learning. And when we talk about reinforcement learning, that time, I think guys, you guys have known about Tesla self-driving car, right? Yes, in the Tesla self-driving car, they have used RL, that is reinforcement learning. In this reinforcement learning, what happened? If your model worked really pretty well, you can give a reward for that. And when your model is not working perfectly, you will get a penalty for that, right? So you can understand, for a layman term, these are the three types of machine learning we have. Now, if we go back to supervised learning, and if I just try to make you understand what is this supervisor I want to mean by. So, in this case, we have a data set. So, let me just show you today's data set, and also I have few other data set as well. I will show you. Right? Let me just show you the other data sets we have, right? In this case. Okay. In this case, what we have. Okay. Let me just show you the data set. Okay, so I got a data set over here. So let it be okay, open, right? So today we are going to use student grade prediction, right? So what we have here, so if you look over here, let me just make it little big. Okay, so if you look over here, what you have school, age, address, fame, size, you have lots of things. Lastly, what you have grade, that is G1, G2 and G3. Can you see? There is a grade you have. But I just want to show you that particular data set, then you will understand what actually I want to mean by that. Right. Okay, so if you look at this data set, we have this diabetes data set. What is this diabetes data set? We have pregnancy column, we have glucose column, blood pressure, skin thickness, insulin, BMI. Right? So in this case, we have information for how many times this particular person was pregnant, then the glucose, then blood pressure. And lastly, you will can see there is a column for outcome. So why do we need this outcome column? This outcome column is nothing but your class. Now you will ask me, what is class? Yes, this particular column is going to say, according to all the information, your person is diabetic or not. So when we talk about this particular part, that time you can say this 1 and 0 are your supervisor. How they are your supervisor? Because they already give you the result according to the information you have. So when you have a already result in your data set, that time you can say your data set is ready, and your data set is basically for supervised learning. So these particular classes are nothing but your teacher for your data set, and this teacher is going to help you to teach your model, right? So this is about supervised learning. If we go back to particularly this part, if you can look at this, we will try to find it out the grade of the student. So you can see this 6 6 6 10 15 10 15, these are the nothing but the continuous value you have. Now there is a two differentiation about in your data set. So first your label data set, second one is your unlabeled data set. So when you have a label like this class particularly, like diabetic or not, according to all the information you have, what is the grade you have for your student, that time it is known as nothing but label data set. When you have a data set without any label, right, you will not have this particular column, right? This output column will not be there. You will have till age. So your model will try to do the clustering by itself, try to understand the data by itself without any help. That time it is known as unsupervised learning. Right? I hope you understand about that. I will answer your question and then we will jump into the one type of algorithm from supervised learning, and then we will do the project. Yes, Rangan, data science includes ML and business analytics. I don't think that data science includes, but yeah, if you know it, it will always help you. Can you name some basics projects using AML? Why don't you check out our playlist, guys? We did lots of live session on machine learning projects. What is the steps of learning machine learning? Okay, Sanjay is asking that. The steps of learning machine learning, you have to start with Python. If you don't know Python, you need to know Python or R. Then you have to go for learning three different types of machine learning algorithms. First supervised, then unsupervised, and then reinforcement learning. Okay, from the last slide, ML mainly used for modeling after data cleaning, which can be used for business analysis, right? Saurabh, you are saying last slide from ML mainly used for modeling. So ML can be used for modeling basically after data cleaning, yes, which can be used for business analysis. Yes, it can be used for business analysis. We do lots of, you know, do things for business analysis to understand our business. Venki is saying, as a fresher, it is difficult to find a job in machine learning and AI side. How can we find a fresher job for? Why? Just try to find an internship. I think that will be best to start your career in this particular domain. Okay. Cool. Any other answer, ma'am? Not. Okay, I get lots of questions, guys. I will answer all of your questions in the later in the section. Difference between unsupervised and reinforcement learning. Okay, we will talk about that. Outcome repeat 0 and 1. Okay, so outcome is nothing but... Right, so I will answer your question again for outcome. Outcome is nothing but your class, right? Your label for the data set. So when you have a label data set, you have to go for supervised learning, right? Yeah, this is pretty much about the data set. We have talked about the types of machine learning. We have talked about already supervised learning. Now we will see one algorithm. But before start the algorithm, understanding, how many of you are interested to learn this particular algorithm? How many of you heard the term linear regression? Yeah. How many of you heard the term linear regression? If you can give me, guys, like a quick heads up on that. It's just my curiosity to understand that this is this a really new term for you, or this is something you have already heard about, the linear regression. Both you can use Anub. R and Python. Rajya is saying I am. Okay, cool. So fine. So what is linear regression? Linear regression, before start with linear regression, let me give you an example of what is regression. Suppose you have your ice cream parlor. I am a very ice cream person. I love to have ice cream. So if you look into your sales, you can see there is a hike in sale of ice cream in summer. That's normal. So in the winter, you will have a very less sale for ice cream, right? So there is a direct connection with weather with the sale of ice cream. Right, so finding out a relationship between two different things, it's basically for regression. So regression stands for to model a target value based on dependent variables, and linear regression is used to find the relationship between dependent and independent variable. Right, so what is basically linear regression? Linear regression is basically trying to find it out the relationship between a dependent variable and the independent variable for x and y, right? So this is the very simple algorithm in machine learning that you can start with. Okay, after that you can say linear regression is a supervised learning that we know. When your data is a labeled data, you can go for using linear regression, and you have to understand your data type as well. So when you have a data with outcome or with class with 0 and 1, you cannot use linear regression. But when your data have a, like, you know, scores like 10, 15, 16, like grade like that, that time you can go for using linear regression because it's a continuous type variable you have, right? So you can say it's always works with continuous value, not with the binary data or the discrete data. Now there is a formula for linear regression formula known as y equals to mx plus c. So I think you guys have idea about y equals to mx plus c. That's the normal straight line formula it is. So where m equals to slope of the line and c equals to intercept, right? Main target for linear regression to find the base value of k and base value for x and y, right? So this is pretty much about linear regression. Now we will start with our project, right? So how many of you are really excited to start with the project of student grade prediction using machine learning? So in the meantime, let me tell you, we are going to use Google Colab. So how many of you have idea about Google Colab and actually worked with Google Colab? So we are going to use one particular IDE for this. This is nothing but Google Colab. We don't need to install anything because there is a reason for Google Colab is supported from Google for AI developers, and you will get lots of new features in Google Colab. So how many of you are having an idea about Google Colab? Nara Shimha, okay. Is data structure SQL needed for LML? Yes, data structure is always needed to have a good understanding about any programming language, and SQL is needed for database management system. Okay, Ritika Sharma is saying, I'm very much excited. Okay, worked with Jupyter. Yeah, you can work with Jupyter, but I love to work with Google Colab, right? So if you guys don't have idea about Google Colab, please check out our video on Google Colab. And for your quick heads up, I will show you how to start with Google Colab. Just write Google Colab in your browser, click on the first link, and here you just need to go to new notebook, right? When you create this particular new notebook, it will automatically give you a workplace where you can actually start with your Python. And you can see this is your notebook place, and here there is a box sign. If you click over here, right, if you click over here, you can see, if you just click over here, right, you can see this is your kernel is connecting. When it will be connected now, you will get an option to upload, right? Here you will get an option to upload to session storage. So if you want to upload your data set, you can click over here, and where you have your data set in the local system, click and enter, right? And one thing you have to remember, that 12 hours thing. So you have your code, your data set for 12 hours in your Google Colab. After that, it will be removed. So whatever you are working with Google Colab, be sure that is saved. Don't forget to save that. Google Colab is not paid, it's free of cost by Google, right? Yeah, so this is pretty much about Google Colab. Now we, as we have taken this particular data set from Kaggle, and you will get all the data set, code book, presentation, everything in the Great Learning Academy. Our moderator is sending you that particular link. Please look at that link. I think that will help you to start with, right? And here we are going to talk about what are the columns we have. So before start with that, we are going to import two particular library for what? For doing this particular project. So first we are going to do a library for Pandas, and we are going to use a library called NumPy. So Pandas is nothing but known as data manipulation library, and NumPy is basically numerical Python library, right? Let me just execute this. So NumPy and Pandas is basically for if you want to manipulate your data, if you want to, you know, load your data, everything can be done using NumPy and Pandas. So now we will talk about the 33 columns we have in our data set. So first we have column called school. So in this case, student school, right? So you have the student has school for whom you are going to trying to predict the, you know, trying to predict the grade. Okay, so binary is GP. That Gabriel, this is something you can see. These are the thing. Okay, let me just make it little big for you guys. So school is basically student school. You can see these are the two types of school we have here. Then we have the gender, right? The female or male. Then we have the age for the student age, the numeric from 15 to 22, right? From there we have address, we have fame size. Fame size is basically family size. Right, then we have P status, then parents cohabitation status, right? So they are living together and they are apart. Okay, then MEDU, that is something called as mother's education, right? That is numeric 0 means none, 1 means primary education, that is 4th grade. Then we have 5th to 9th grade, then we have 3rd grade, right? So this is something about the student's mother education. Then we have FEDU, that is father's education. Then we have mother's job. Then we have father's job, right? Then we have guardian, the student guardian. Then travel time. So we will try to understand that a student is traveling how much home to school travel time, right? Then we have study time, that how many time they are going to study in a week. Then we have failures, number of past classes failures we have, right? So these are lots of things we have, you can see. About the student, and lastly we have the grade of G1, G2 and G3, right? So if we try to read our data, we will going to use a particular function called pd.read.csv. So when we are trying to call pd.read.csv, we need to give the dataset path. How will you get the dataset path? If you go over here and if you just see, you can if you can see three dots over here, if you click over here and just click on copy path, right, then your data will be copied. Now I try to understand our data in a more precise way. How to do that? We are going to use a function called dot head function. This dot head function is going to give you the first 5 rows of your data, right? So in this case you can see we have our data over here. Okay, so you can see this is something data.head. So guys, do you have any doubt till so far before going to any data analysis, right? For whatever we have learned so far, I will wait for a few more seconds and then we will go for the next part of the session. Thank you, Minahil. Thanks. Thank you so much. What types of data use in supervised and unsupervised learning? For supervised learning, we used level data. For unsupervised learning, we use unlabeled data. Brajendro. Okay, Vivek Mishra, we will try to do come up with the session for NER, right? Or a natural language processing library with SPACY, right? We will try to come up with that. For that, please do hit like this particular session and please do comment after this particular session then what new idea you guys have. Right, and guys, don't spam in the live chat. This is my request to you. Don't spam in the live chat. Right, Okay, so you can see this is all about the dataset loading we have learned about. Now we will see the final grade. So what is our final grade? G3 will be our final grade, right? So if you try to get only particular column from your data set, what you need to do, you just need to write data G3. This column name is G3, then dot describe. As we have talked about the EDA part. EDA part is something, EDA was something like exploratory data analysis, right? So in this case, you can see dot describe we use to understand our data. What is the mean of our data? What is the standard deviation of the particular, that particular column? What is the minimum value you have in that particular column? Then what is IQR? That is nothing but interquartile range you have in your data, right? For this particular column. Let me just do that. So for G3, you can see the total count you have, that 395 rows you have. Then you have mean value 10.4. Then you have standard deviation is 4.58, right? Sachin, for that we need to understand is all the attributes useful to make that particular model. We will talk about that. Rajya, can you tell us about Google Colab? For Google Colab, why don't you go and check out our video on Google Colab? I think that will help you to understand about Google Colab, guys. Okay, now what we need to do, we try to understand our, you know, data set in using Matplotlib and Seaborn. So this is nothing but your data visualization. Now you can see what we are going to use. We have used this SNS. What is SNS? We have used two particular library. One is Seaborn, one is Matplotlib, right? For Seaborn and Matplotlib, we are going to do a count plot. What count plot? The final grade, right? We try to understand what are the students we have and what is the major, you know, up and downs for this final grade from 0 to 20. So what we have done, we have used a count plot. So count plot is automatically count the same grade and it will give you a bar graph for that, right? So here you can see the final grade we take, that is data of G3, and we have written the distribution of final grade of students. Right, and font size we have given 35. You can make it 25 as well, as it's very big. Right, can you see this is the final grade, and you can see the most of the student you have the grade in 10 to 11. Right, can you see 10 to 11 student you have, they have the final grade. The most of the student have 10 to 11. Right, so this is how you can, like, you know, read your data using this particular technique, that is data visualization. Now, if you try to understand what are the columns you have in your data set, right? So in this case, if you just write data dot columns, it will return all the columns you have in your data set. Can you see the 33 columns we have talked about? All the column you will get over here. Now, if you say, hey, I want to check the shape of my data set, shape is basically going to return you what are the columns you have, what are the, you know, what are the shapes you have, like basically rows you have, like the total count of that. If you just write data dot shape, it's going to give you the total row count and then the total, you know, column count. Okay, now if you want to check, is there any missing value do I have in your data set? Because yeah, from like basically you will understand why do we need to understand the missing value. You need to understand missing value because we don't want to work with a missing value data set, because that will not going to give us a good result out of it, right? So in this case we have used two particular function. One is isNull function, one is dot any function. So basically when you try to give dot isNull, is going to give you a, you know, true or false, okay? And if you give dot any, it will try to find it out for each and every column, do you have any null value in your data set. You can see for all of them it's showing false. So basically your data set is really good and you don't have any null value in your data set. Now if you just use dot sum instead of any, it's basically going to give you a total sum of the null value you have in your data set. So all of the cases you can see this is zero, right? So now I just want to understand the total male student, right? Total male student and total female student, right? So what we need to do, we try to use a like, you know, length function, and where we have used the sex equals to male. When it's sex equals to female, it will give the length out of it, right? So if you just write male student and female student, right? If you just do that, you can see the number of male student is 187 and number of female student is 208. So basically it's going to give you, you can see the female students are high in number in your data set, right? So now if we just try to understand a few other things, right? So in this case, maybe we will try to do a average of the grade average. How to do that? So you have G1, G2, G3, and you can just directly do the average out of it. The data of G1 plus data of G2 plus data of G3 divided by 3, right? You will get the average out of it, right? Now, if you try to make a data, like, you know, if you try to map your data, okay, using this particular one, you can do that. Basically, you can write that 90% above, you need to give a grade A. If it's 70% and 90% above, you will get a grade B. And if it's 70% above, you will get a give a grade C. You can do that, right? Using this, mapping this particular grade average. And if you don't want to do that, you can actually skip this particular part as well, right? So, in this case, what you need to do, we are trying to drop two particular column. What are these two particular column? We are trying to drop school and age, right? Why? Because school and age is not going to give us any sort of, you know, school and age is not at all useful maybe for our particular model making. That's why we are going to drop these particular two column, right? Okay, it's already dropped, that's why it's giving me error. Cool. After that, if you just do this particular data dump dot head, you can see, and if you want to check what are the columns you have, you can see this particular dot columns. If you just write this, right, what the columns you will get, you will get this, all these things, right? So we have dropped school and age. So school and age is not there over here, you can see. Now we are going to do the mapping. What type of mapping we are going to do? If you can look over here, you can see we are going to map with 0 and 1. Why? Because this all the data we have in string, that's not going to work with our model. So we try to make it in a categorical value with 0 and 1. Yes is 1, no is 0, using dot map function. Right, for all the cases we just need to do this particular data encoding, you can say. This is categorical value, we are changing it to categorical value. Lastly, when you have done this, we try to use our data in X. We are going to use all the data except G3. We try to find our G3 for the student, and you can see we are going to use scikit-learn over here. So why do we need to use scikit-learn? Scikit-learn is the, you know, library for machine learning. You can use all the machine learning algorithm using scikit-learn, and where this all the things are already, you know, explained, implemented. You just need to call this particular algorithm and your work is done, right? So now if you look at X-train, X-test, Y-train, Y-test, we will going to like divide our data set in four different forms. One is for training, one is for testing. So you will have four parts of your data. Now we are going to actually import linear regression from scikit-learn, right? And we will call linear regression, okay? And if you just try to train your model, you have to call l.fit, right? If you just call l.fit, and if you just give your train data set, and then if you just write l.predict, it's going to predict, right, what will be the G3 for your students for the testing data. Now you can see, if you just want to check the score of the linear regression, you can see 77% your model is working accuracy with the new data. So you can say your model is working really pretty fine, and you can actually make more, you can do some other techniques like data normalization, missing value treatment, outlier analysis. If you do all these things, your accuracy will obviously increase. Yes, Gandham, I say that linear regression is only for continuous values. You can see if you just go to the data set itself, G3 is a continuous value. Can you see 6, 10, 15? These are the continuous value. Your G3 is a continuous value. That's why we have used linear regression. Searching for checking, important one. I just don't want to, make a complicated one. We can do a correlation for that to understand what are the columns you really need for your model, to make the model. But in this case, we have actually dropped two particular columns. One is school, one is age. Right? So guys, I hope it's actually helped you to understand, to get started with machine learning, one particular project in machine learning, that student grade prediction. Right? I hope you guys like the session, and if you like the session, then please do hit like it and also subscribe Great Learning. And please go and skill up yourself using Great Learning Academy. You will get lots of free courses over there, and also there are lots of study material you will get for free. Right? Thank you guys, thank you so much for attending the session. I think you like it, and please do let us know your new ideas in the comment section. Thank you, bye bye, we'll see you in the next session. Thank you.